Today, we're going to talk about the specific category. Within the specific category, we can conduct a wide range of flights that we could not do in the open one. Like, for example, we could be flying in populated environments in visual line of sight, we could be conducting drone delivery applications, or we could be flying really heavy drones. For flying in the specific category, we will have to go through what we call a specific operation risk assessment. This basically entails evaluating the risk, the ground risk first, which means what do we have underneath the drone all the time? Are we above a crop or are we above a demonstration of people in the middle of a city, right? The second thing we have to do is take into account the air risk. Are we flying in the middle of nowhere or we are flying in a controlled airspace? Based on that, we can propose some mitigations to decrease the risk of these two things. And at the end, we're going to get a SAIL number, which stands for Specific Assurance Integrity Level. Now, if we get a SAIL number 1 or 2, we're going to have a low risk operation. If we get a 3 or 4, it's going to be medium. And if we have 5 or 6, we're going to have a high risk operation. What happens if your operation falls into the low category class? If you're flying in low category class, you may encounter what we call the standard scenario, STS. These are evaluations already made by EASA, and they establish a set of rules like or limitations like safety distances, flight height, documentation, training requirements, etc. With the STS, you no longer have to submit documentation to EASA or your national authority. You don't have to submit, but you just have to declare that you comply with all the requirements published in the standard scenario. If we don't meet the requirements of the standard scenario, we have another option called Predefined Risk Assessment, or PDRA. The PDRA are a document published by EASA that facilitate the specific operation risk assessment. This way, drone operators only have to carry out the necessary documentation to satisfy the security objectives that are indicated. Over time, a PDRA can become standardized in such a way that they can turn into standard scenarios. In case the resulting SAIL number is a 3 or 4, you'll be operating in the medium risk. For operating the medium risk, you will have to conduct what we call the operational authorization. And this time, you will have to submit this documentation into the National Aviation Authority and wait for their approval. It is also possible that the National Competent Authority should require the design verification process of the whole aircraft or one of the subsystems. This evaluation is a separate procedure through which you will certify that the aircraft meets the necessary specifications to be able to operate safely in the requested scenarios. And finally, if the resulting SAIL number is 5 or 6, you will be obliged to pass through an airworthiness certification process. So, as we have seen, the specific category offers a wide range of possibilities and offers not only one option to proceed. So, according to the SAIL number you have, you will proceed in one way or another. So if you have any questions relating to your operation, please drop us a line. We're going to be happy to help you.